Hey there. So in this video, we're going to model the same architectural form using three different methods. We'll start with the fastest way, then move on to the most precise technique, and at the end, we're going to compare the results of each approach. It's going to be super fun to see which one works best. So stick around. Hey there, hello, I'm so glad you're here. I'm Harseen, and in this video, we're going to dive into three super simple methods for modeling this complex shape using Rhino. Each method is going to teach you something new, and trust me, it's going to boost your modeling speed and accuracy like you wouldn't believe. So let's get started and have some fun with this. Okay, so before you do anything, like just simplify the form in your mind, right? It's got like just two parts. There's the spiral ramp, and then there's the outer shell. All right, so like first step is we create a simple member, right? And then we just repeat that. And oh, we give it some curves with CageEdit. Super neat, huh? Then we prepare the columns using pipe. And for the ramp, we just like use extrude. The second method, right? It's like the initial part is way more open. So the shell kind of just forms on its own, you know? But we got to sync up the ramp with CageEdit, and then like all the other details get added in just like before. The third method, right? It's super simple. You just take a vertical line and then, wait for it, you spin it around. Then you mirror it and, oh, with CageEdit, you clean up the shape like really nice and tidy. And finally, ta-da, the columns and ramps are all set to go. Hey, so like if you're really into, you know, getting more training on Rhino modeling and you want to like learn all those pro techniques, you should totally subscribe and hit that bell icon. It's going to be awesome.